What is up, YouTube? In this video, we are going to look at Python fundamentals that are required for data engineering. For data engineering, even though Python is like really core to it, but at the end of the day, you need to treat it as a means to the end. No need to get bogged down into the details on how everything's kind of put together. But instead, you need to learn how to kind of use this programming language like as a powerful tool for your specific use cases. All right, to understand fundamentals of Python, especially for around data engineering, I think it's best to use it by example. This is basically a bare bones ETL pipeline. But essentially, it's an ETL pipeline. You need to think about that, where you kind of extract the data, transform it, and finally load it into the right place. So yeah, you need to understand things are not as complex, especially for a newbie or a beginner. Like you might feel it as complex, but let's just go through the example to explain a bit more about how simple it is to use Python to achieve ETL. So the first step is, in terms of using Python, is importing the right libraries. The good thing about Python is it has an ecosystem of super libraries around data and general programming, so that it's like easy to use and readily available for us to use. So the first step, the first three libraries I'm using is request libraries. Request library, which is used to pull data from an API, which is basically for extraction data. Pandas is a library to do transformation manipulation of data. You can think of Excel on steroids, but using code. So you can use pandas to read data in terms of Excel formats, CSV formats, in a tabular format, basically. You can easily transform it using pandas. And the last is SQL Alchemy. I'm using this to create a connection to a database. Essentially, it's a SQL-like database. So the first step in the process is obviously extract. E stands for extract. So in this sample, we are extracting from an API source, which is freely available for us to use. It's basically pulling out the universities available in the United States as a whole. When you run this API, the API basically gives data back to us in a JSON format. So yeah, you get this data in terms of this structure. It's basically text with fields, something like that. It's the bare bones structure being used in HTTPS calls or HTTP calls. So we get this data as an output from this URL. We use request library to kind of achieve that and get it, get a response as a JSON, essentially, which is a dictionary within Python. That's the first step. Next step, which is transform. So you need the data to be in the right format. And a lot of the times, the transformation is also around like business conditions. For example, in this case, as a hypothetical condition, we only wanted to get the data for all the universities in California. So what we have done, I'm just going to go through steps one by one. We get the data in a dictionary. The first step we do is read it into a pandas data frame. So pandas data frame is like a data structure. It is a library we use. So we convert this dictionary into a data frame. You can essentially think of a data frame as a CSV, which has rows and columns, basically. And then there's like a lot of added functionality you can do. Very comprehensive tool in terms of transforming the data. So there's a few things I'm doing. The first thing is like a filter. I filter out all the universities whose name contains California. So pandas is like Excel on steroids, where I'm able to do from a simple syntax, I can filter out things, I can put filters, I can transform things. It's very easy to do. The thing to get confused about, this is just a syntax to achieve things. So you can see DF is a data frame. So essentially, a data frame is a CSV within memory. So it has an index. These are the columns. You can put up filters on these columns. So these are the domains of these universities, the country of the university, the website links, and the name of the university. So what I'm doing, and in this one, I'm doing a filter. First of all, a filter on all the universities which have California. So I'm just getting out all the Californian universities, because then the additional column of state doesn't work out. The next step is I'm converting, because then the data should be in the right format. It basically contains a list of domains within each column. I don't want a list of domains. Like, I want a list of domains, but not in a list, but in a comma separated format. So this is what I'm doing here in both of these steps. So domains, like it's like a list, and then I'm converting into a string using comma, both of these columns. And then I'm dropping the index because I'm just doing a filter, right? And then I'm only returning the desired column, which I want to store. So you can easily see how the transform step kind of looks like. You can easily imagine all of these steps in an Excel when you're doing it manually. Last step is load. So the load is we are creating a SQLite database, basically reading a SQLite database which exists in memory. Essentially, it is a database that exists in my disk, not in memory, sorry. This can be a database on a host or a server somewhere. You can just consider it very similar. And then I'm kind of saving this data frame into a table. So I'm doing a data frame dot T2SQL. So basically it's a functionality of pandas object. I can do a 2SQL into a table. I have to provide the engine. Basically this is a SQLite engine. And I need to provide a condition that if the data exists, just replace it. So this is the next step of loading. After we have the transform data, we perform the load into a database. These are the functions. A function is aspect of a programming language where you can just reuse this set of code again and again. Basically, logically separate the action, and that's what I'm doing. I have a function for extract, I have a function for transform and load. So as a next step, I need to execute this function because this still is not executing. So the first step is to get the data out of extract. I get this data in a dictionary format or JSON format, and then I pass it to a transform function which has the data. I pass in the data, which is the dictionary. In response, after all the transformation, I get a data frame with all these columns. And then after I get the data frame, all these columns, I do a load into a SQLite database. So yeah, let's just keep quickly run it. Shift enter. All right. All this code kind of ran, and we haven't executed any function yet because that's why it did not take time. The next step should take time because the first thing is you're going to get the data out of this API. So let's just execute this. We're getting a data. We are extracting the data. After that, we are transforming it, and then we are loading it. All right. So you can see I've added a few print statements within the whole process. So you can say the total number of universities from the API we got was 4362 of United States. And then we only filter for Californian universities. And we are only getting all these columns to be saved up. So yeah, and then after that, the transformation, we are loading it into a SQLite database, which is essentially living in our file explorer, this one. I have a database client to connect to this database, basically to read the data, to show like all the data has been placed. So you can see there's only one table, Cal Uni, and you can browse the data within that explorer. And you can see the columns, index, domains, country, web pages, and name are here now. And it's been saved in the right structure. You can see this column is like a comma separated string. So it's saving both of these web pages URL together. So yeah, all of this is like looks quite simple, right? It's nothing too fancy, nothing too complex, but as a base, you should understand this is how the whole ETL process works. This is how you use Python to kind of achieve what you want, like in terms of extract, transform, load. So hence covering the overall fundamentals around data engineering for Python. You don't need to know everything under Python, all the different types of data structure. You can always learn as you go. That's the fundamental thing I want to highlight is you can always learn as you go. Always start with the basic, start with the use case. Maybe a small sample always. In this case, we're just doing an ETL, a very simple one, but it kind of explains the role of Python in the world of data engineering. That's about it for this video. If you like this one, definitely hit the like button and subscribe to my channel. It really helps me a lot to push my content to people like you.